Hello students, I hope you are all well. Okay, so today we are going to start with the second part of the chapter, that is chapter number 4, cube roots. Okay, for some of you this might be the first time to understanding the cube roots. Okay, so finding out the root of any perfect cube number, that is what we are going to study in this chapter. Okay, as well as in our course also, we only required to find out the cube root of a perfect cube number. Okay, the question will be not like that in the squares case. Okay, there was another method to find out the square root of any perfect square number, that was by division method. All the division method is no longer part of your course for perfect square method, but there we know that there exists a method to find out the square root of non-perfect square number. Okay, so for cube root of a perfect cube number, we have a simple method, that is of prime factorization method. First of all, let me explain what is a cube root. Okay, you have a number 3, and if you cube the number, then it is 27. Okay, cube root of a number is expressed as this, and cube root of 27 will be 3. Okay, cube root of 27 will be 3. In some books it is also written as, cube root is also written as power 1 upon 3. So if I am writing power of a number 1 upon 3, that means I am writing its cube root. If I am writing cube root of 3 like this, the square root sign and 3 written at the top here, then it is called cube root of 3, cube root of 27. The answer in each case is 3. Okay, I will quote the example as it is given in your book. Suppose you are given the volume of a cube. Okay, in mensuration chapter in the previous classes, you have learned that volume of a cube is a cube. Okay, suppose you are given the volume of a cube is 27. Suppose you are given that the volume of a cube is 27 cubic meter. You have to find its sides. How will you do it? You will determine that the prime factors or the factors of this number, you will form the pair and you will determine the side as 3. Okay. So in this exercise, we will learn how to identify, how to determine the cube of any given number. Okay. Or whether the number, given number is a perfect cube or not. Okay. So we'll start with the question. With the help of the question, I will show you how to find the cube of any cube root of any given number. Okay, the exercise 4.2, first part of the question. Okay, in question number 1, first question is given to you as, find the cube root of each of the following by definition. Find the cube root of each of the following by definition. This is exercise 4.2, page number 69. Okay. So, first one is you have to determine the cube root of 7 cube. Okay. Cube root of 7 cube means 7 into 7 into 7. Okay. So, 7 cube is 7 into 7 into 7. So, there are how many 7s? 3 7s. You take 1 7 outside and that is your answer. Okay. Aap logo ko kya karna hai? You have to form a pair of 3 of prime factors. Take 1 number outside of each of the pair. Okay. As we move on with the difficult question, you will get the better gist of the solution. Second is minus 13 cube. You have to find its cube root. Okay. So this will be minus 13 into minus 13 into minus 13. And you have to determine its cube root. This will be minus 13. In the same manner, third part can be written as minus 125. Cube root of minus 125 can be written as cube root of minus 5 into minus 5 into minus 5. Okay, and the answer will be minus 5. Next is 2700. I will leave that part to you. Okay, I hope you can get it. Now, let us try to find out the cube root by prime factorization method. In question number 5 to 12, we have to determine the cube root of numbers using prime factorization method. Okay. So, first of all, let me make something clear. If a number is negative, then its cube root will also be negative. If a number is positive, then its cube root will be positive. Write down a note. If a number is negative, then its cube root is also negative. Okay, and if a number is positive, then its cube root is also positive. So, if you have a negative number, its cube root is also negative. If you have a positive number, its cube root is also positive. Keeping all this in mind, we will just determine the cube root of a number using the prime factorization, and we will add plus or minus sign as given in the question. So let me take an example, question number 6. Question number 5 is quite easy, that is why I am not taking it. Question number 6 is, you have to find the cube root of minus 9261. Okay, using prime factorization. So what is prime factorization? This is prime factorization, 9261. Okay. So, first of all, I will start with 3, 3 3s are 9, 0, 3 8s are 24, 3 7s are 21, okay. How I determined that this number can be divisible by 3? Because when I add all of these digits, the answer is 9, okay. That is why this number is divisible by 3. Next, 3, 3 1s are 3, 0, 3 2s are 6, 3 9s are 27. Again 3, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12 and 3. And 3 4 3, as we already know, is a cube of 7. Now what we need to do is, we need to write it as, we have to determine cube root of, okay. I am taking all the numbers as negative. Minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3. And in continuation, minus 7 into minus 7 into minus 7. Sorry about this. In continuation, you will write minus 7 into minus 7 into minus 7. Okay, so what is happening here is, there is a pair of minus 3s and there is a pair of minus 7s. Okay. Out of all of these minus 3s, I take 1 minus 3 outside, okay. And out of all of these minus 7, out of all of these minus 7, I take 1 7, sorry, plus 7. We will only make one pair as negative, okay. We will only make one pair as negative. Otherwise, if I were to multiply all this, the answer would have been positive, okay. So, this is plus 7, plus 7 and plus 7. Out of all these plus 7, we take 1, 7 outside. You multiply them, minus 3 into 7 is minus 20. And if you are confused about the negative sign, agar aap negative sign ke baare mein confused hain, to just find out the cube root of 9261 aur uske baad uske aage minus ka sign laga dena. Okay, that way your solution is also correct. Taking another question, 7th, This is 5832. Okay. So first of all, we have to determine cube root of 5832. We have to find its vector. I am going to do this a bit directly. 5832. First of all, 2. 2 2s are 4. 2 9s are 18. 2 1s are 2. 2 6s are 2. 2 1s are 2. 2 4s are 8. 2 5s are 10. And 2 8s are 16. 2 7s are 14. 2 2s are 4. 2 9s are 18. And 7 to 9 is 3. 2 4 3. 3 81. 3 27. 3 9. 3 3 and finally 3 1. Okay, I will make the pair of prime vectors here only. So this is one pair, this is second pair, and this is third pair. Out of this pair, I will take 1 2, out of this 1 3, out of this 1 3. And you multiply all of these numbers, 2 into 3 into 3 is 9 to the 18. So, cube of 18 is 5832, cube root of 5832 is 18. In this manner, you can do all of the questions. Let's just try some more questions. Let us try question number 10. Question number 10 is, we have to find out the cube root of 74088. So once again, we will use the prime factorization method. 74088. First of all, by 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 7s are 14, 0 as it is 4 4, 2 1s are 2, 2 8s are 16, 2 5s are 10, 2 2, 2 9s are 18, 2 2s are 4, 2 6s are 12, 2 1s are 2. 9 to 6 1, we have already done about 9 to 6 1. 9 to 6 1 was first of all by 3, 3 3s are 9, 0, 3 8s are 24, 3 7s are 21, 3 1 0, 3 2s are 6, 3 9s are 27, 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, and then we had 7 49, 7 7 7 and 1. So there is one pair of 7, there is one pair of 3, and there is one pair of 2. 7 3s are 21, 21 2s are 42. So cube root of 74088 will be 42. Okay. So this is what we are going to do in the whole exercise. We are just going to find out the cube root of a number using prime factorization. And as I have already told you, last exercise of the chapter is no longer part of your syllabus. So you don't have to bother yourself with the pattern questions in this chapter. Okay. Pattern questions can become from the third chapter, that is squares and square roots. But pattern questions for this chapter are not important for you. And once again, let me again remind you, Vedic mathematics is no longer part of your syllabus, as have been recounted by CBSE. Okay. Now, moving on, let us take one more question, 12th question, okay. This is question number 12. You have to find out the cube root of 250047. Sorry about this. 250047. 4 plus 7 is 11. 11 plus 5 is 16. 16 plus 2 is 18. So it is divisible by 3. 3 8s are 24. 3 3s are 9. 3 3s are 9. 3 2s are 12. 3 9s are 27. 3 2s are 6. 3 7s are 21. 3 7s are 21. 3 7s are 21. There is a mistake. This is 10. 10 plus 9, 27. So 3 2s are 6. 2 carry 23. 3 three sevens are 21, 23, three sevens are 21, and 22. Let me do the long division. There is some mistake I have done. 3 8s are 24, correct. 1 carry, 3 3s are 9. 1 carry, 3 3s are 9. 1 carry, 3 4s are 12. And 2 carry, 27. Okay. Then after that, 3 2s are 6. 2 carry. 3 7s are 21. Again, 2 carry. Then 3 7s are 21. Again, 2 carry. 6. Oh, I made a mistake. No, it is correct. I'm doing correct till now, right? And then this should be. There's some mistake. Let me do the long division, okay? I'm getting confused here. This can happen sometimes when we get confused. It is better to use the long division. Don't go to the calculator directly. 3 2s are 6, 2 carry 3. 3 7s are 21, 2 carry, then 3. 3 7s are 21, 2 carry, then 2. 3 7s are 21, 1, 9. And then we will have 18. So there is a problem. 8 plus 3, 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 plus 9 is 19. Okay. There is some mistake in here. I've done some mistake. 3 should 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 5 is 11. 11 plus 7 is 18. So it might be possible that this is not a perfect cube. Let me check the answer first of all. I'm checking the answer right now to see whether this is a valid question or not. This was 12th question. Answer is 63. 63 is 9 7s are 63, but this number is not multiple of 9. There must be some calculation mistake with me. Let me do it again. Okay. Sometimes when we sometimes when I lose my flow, this things happens. I lose the focus. Okay, first of all, I'm dividing 250047 with 3. 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 1 0. 3 3s are 9, 1 0. 3 3s are 9, 1, 4, 3 4s are 12, 2, 7, 3 9s are 27. So this is 8, 3, 3, 4, 9. Okay, let us start with 7. 7 1 is 7, 2, 7 3s are 21, 2, 7 3s are 20. Okay, this was the mistake. I wrote 2 here instead of 4. See, I got my mistake. Earlier I had written it as 2. This time I got it correct. So we will do again with 3. Why 3? Because 8 plus 3 plus 3. 8 plus 6 plus 4. Okay, this is divisible by 3. Total is 27. So this is 3 2s are 6. Once again. And 3 7s are 21, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 3 3s are 9, 27, 10, 27. Again, by 3, 3 9s are 27, 3 2s are 6, 3 9s are 18, 3 1s are 3. And 9 2, 1 9, 3 2s are 6. Once again, I think I have made some mistake. Once again, 3 6s are 18. This will be 9261. And 9261 we have encountered earlier. This will be 3 3s are 9, 0, 3 8s are 24, 3 7s are 21. 3 1s are 3, 0 3 2s are 6, 3 9s are 27, and then 3 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, and once we have 3 4 3, it is 7 49 7 7 and 7 1. Okay, with this one is complete. Whew. I made lots of mistake here. So one pair is 3, one pair again 3, and next pair is 7. So your answer will be 3 into 3 into 7, 9 7s are 63. Okay. Next is question is, for the questions number 3, 13, 14, 15 and 16, question is, by the method of finding the unit digits and 10 digits of cube root, find the cube root of each of the following. You need not to bother with such questions, okay? Just find out the cube root like we have done till now. Just find out the cube roots of question number 13, 14, 15, 16 like we have done till now, okay? No need to introduce new method here. Prime factorization is okay with this for the finding out of the cube root, okay? So that's all for today. Thank you for your time. Have a nice day.